Hi friends, it's another Jeep video. So last time I did a video, I was working on aligning the steering wheel, and I realized that somebody, trying not to cuss, oh the hell with it, some asshat loosened the adjustment clamp. So whatever. So anyway, there is a clamp right here. And by turning it one way or the other, you can move this in or out so I can adjust the steering wheel. And that's something that should have been done. It's probably been screwed up since they put a suspension lift in it, because that's one of the things that will screw up your steering wheel alignment. Anyway, so what I'm going to work on now is I got to put the track bar back in. And until the track bar is back in, this adjustment doesn't really mean shit. So we're going to get after this. I thought I had lost the stupid bolt. You know, these things are like $30 for this stupid flag bolt and this the bolt and the little flag nut. Anyway, oops, that was $30. Anyway, I'm gonna get after this and I'm gonna get installed. So let me position the camera where you guys can watch me cuss and swear at this. I'll be right back. So the first thing we gotta do is get under here and get some light. Fortunately, this is a Jeep. There is no shortage of stuff that is magnetic. And then let's just see how bad we are. I need to come over maybe a quarter of an inch. And I don't think I can do it from here, maybe. So what you aren't able to see, Hang on, stupid thing. Oh yeah, it's down here. So one of the tricks I'm using is to turn the steering, because the steering will shift the suspension one way or the other. And so y'all aren't going to be able to see that, but if you reach up, you can turn the steering. Okay, so we'll just stick that there, and then that's a good way to get a nice bruise. This would be a lot easier with two people. almost there.
This would be so much easier with second person.
Back this off so you guys can actually see what I'm doing. Quite have enough leverage last time. Again, somebody sitting at the steering wheel would make this would make this really, really easy. It's just hard to do by yourself. One thing that might make this easier. Yeah, that'll work. Thank you. not get it to line up, which is frustrating for sure. Seems really close. All right, what else can I do? See if I can change the distance by raising the right side. See what that did. Not much. What I need is to come along to force the frame and suspension back where I want it. Thank you. go find Come Along. I'll be back.
Alright, I've got the Come Along here. And what I gotta do now is extend it. Find a place to anchor to. Let's see. Pull the frame that way. That isn't going to work either. At least not at that angle. This wasn't this difficult the first time. So this is in my way. It's an angle thing at this point. I think I got a solution. I need to get all this rigging shit out of here and bring it to torque, which is 50 foot-pounds. Thank you.
All right, so that's 50 foot-pounds. That's in tightening mode. This one's 50 foot-pounds or not. I think it is, track bar. Let me double check. Oh, it says 60 bar. No. 40, but that's good enough. I think that just happens to be the number for this as well. So now let's deal with the steering alignment. Alright, so that looks like it's frontwards. We're off by a little bit. Let's see what that did. Made it worse. Yep, that's the direction we need to go. A little less. That's almost spot on. So now we're going to go ahead and tighten these. And before we do, we're going to put some thread lock on them because these aren't something that I want coming apart. So the trick to this is to push up so it locks in, and we need a deeper socket. Fucking kidding me. I gotta find a 15 deep. I'll be right back. So, I don't have any in 3/8. Well, or I have them, but I have no idea where it's at. Let's get the torque wrench going. so that puts us on 50. Another problem solved on this Jeep for today. Hope you all enjoyed this, and hope it helps somebody with their project Jeep. Stay tuned. Make sure you subscribe. Let me know what you think in the comments. And as always, thanks for watching.